Larry Boy called Alfred on his belt radio.
I think now would be a good time for you to tell me how I can stop this fly,
he said. Alfred checked the computer.
According to my calculations,
he answered,
you can do nothing.
Larry Boy couldn't believe his ears.
Nothing?
He yelled. They were in big trouble. If Larry Boy couldn't stop the fly, they'd be eaten for sure.
Which one of you guys should I eat first?
The fly bellowed. Just then, Larry Boy's radio crackled to life.
I made a discovery!
Alfred shouted.
You cannot stop the fly, but someone else can!
What?
Larry Boy asked, but Alfred didn't know yet. His computer was still working on it.
Sort of look like candy.
The monster rumbled and lifted Larry Boy toward his huge mouth.
Alfred!
Screamed our hero.
We have no time!
It's faking!
Alfred yelled back as the computer began drawing a picture. The answer was coming, but was it too late? Larry Boy was almost in the lie's mouth.
Goodbye, bubbly bird!
He moaned. Back in the Larry cave, Alfred stared at the screen. His eyes widened. It was Junior! He yelled into the radio.
Junior can stop the lie!
Junior thought hard. How could he stop the lie? Then it came to him.
I did it!
He screamed.
I broke the plate!
Suddenly, the monster started shrinking like a leaky balloon. The more Junior confessed, the more the lie shrunk. With a final pop, the lie vanished completely.
I'm really sorry about your plate,
Junior told his dad as Larry Boy lowered him to the ground.
I'm sure it was an accident,
his father said.
I just wish you would have told me right away.
Junior said he had learned that even though telling the truth isn't always the easiest way, it is always the best way. Elsewhere in the city, another fib landed in another neighborhood, looking for someone to help him grow.
Alfred, I've got work to do. Consider our game
postponed.
There's only one.